it's kind of consumed our life together.
This is for you to come in and look at and enjoy.
It gives us a connection with our neighbors and the community.
And the culmination is on Halloween night, we get to scare the crap out of people.
We met 46 or 7 years ago.
My roommate in Hawaii was dating her best friend. One thing led to another, and we eventually were able to get married.
We started 37 years ago.
We were in Tacoma, Washington at that time.
It started with a big spider that we built, and then a little graveyard, and then he decided he wanted a coffin so he could scare the kids when they came for trick-or-treating, and then it just grew and grew from there.
Be afraid. I don't bite.
Well. My grandmother had a candy store near Chicago, and she loved Halloween, and she would get the kids treats and caramel apples and everything for Halloween. She loved watching them come in their costumes. And then she would go home and she'd give them the full-size candy bars, and everybody in town came to her. When she was passing away, it was Halloween time. And she sent my uncle home from the hospital to give out candy because she didn't want to upset the kids. And she passed away on Halloween.
It really impressed me when we were sitting in the hospital that she sent her son home to make sure that the kids weren't disappointed.
So we did it as a tribute to her to start with, and then it grew and grew and grew into this big thing. Our one son and daughter-in-law helps us.
I have veteran friends that come and help set up.
It takes 2 months to set up.
We try and move everything out into its position and then bring characters in and set the characters into position. Constantly at night, we're checking the lighting to make sure that it's aimed where we want it so that it works and adds to the scenery to make it more scary.
We usually start by getting the garage set up to build the rooms in there.
We have set up now projections that are shining on the side of the house and things like that in the windows to add to the atmosphere of it looking like a haunted house.
The people drive by, the kids are all hooping and hollering because they know we're starting.
Oh, thank you. Happy Halloween.
And we do take the place of some of the characters that are in the yard a lot of times. So the kids in the neighborhood that come every day doesn't know what's going to be alive. So that's the fun of it for us. The kids in the neighborhood will come up and say, "You can tell me, I won't tell anybody." But it's top secret, we don't tell anybody what we're going to be.
Once everything's set up and the culmination is on Halloween night, we get to scare the crap out of people.
When it's still light out, the little kids come because they'll be too scared most of the time to come at night. It changes at night.
Hearing them scream makes me smile to myself.
Everybody in our family comes. My brothers come. Friends come from Ohio to help us. Our grandkids have done it since they were little. So we had 2-year-olds helping us scare. Now they're 8 through 21. And they come every year and they pick out who their character's going to be and what they're going to wear. And
I'll realize that one of my grandkids or that one of my kids has now scared them because they weren't expecting them to move.
Having everybody here for the holiday is really fun. When people started coming to our haunt and more people came, we decided
Happy
that
Halloween.
there's always a need in the community.
I talked with Kathy and I said, we have all these people coming here and they're asking me if I charge for this, and I say, no, I don't charge for this. This is for you to come in and look at and enjoy and have fun with.
So we started with the food pantry. We usually get about 14 to 1800 pounds of food for the food pantry.
Canned goods?
Yeah.
They just go in this bag, in right here.
Okay.
And yep. Veterans are near and dear to our hearts, so we decided to do the Veterans Freedom Center. And I don't know what our tally is this year for money, but the last 2 years it's been $5,000. The day after Halloween, we start thinking about our next projects or what we want to build or make, what we need for the next year. And so it's just it's kind of consumed our life together. So it's just something that we love to do.
As it stands right now, we're planning on our children. We've asked them several times if they would continue to do this. Maybe not here in Dubuque, but you know, somewhere. And they have all unanimously agreed to continue this operation. So I know that when Kathy and I are gone, that this will continue. Thank you.